And here is the Writer's Almanac for Tuesday, the 14th of April, 2020. 1828, on this date, Noah Webster's American Dictionary of the English Language was published. It came at a time when Americans could hardly communicate with each other because regional dialects were so drastically different. Noah Webster was a school teacher. The textbooks in his school were from England. The student spelling was terrible. Bad spelling was a general condition in America. People assumed that there were several different spellings for any word. So he'd put together a spelling book. It was Webster who took the letter U out of English words like color and honor. And he spelled theater and center E-R instead of R-E. And he started compiling his dictionary, introducing American words, some of them derived from Native American languages: skunk, squash, wigwam, hickory, opossum, lengthy, and presidential, and Congress, and caucus, which were not so relevant in England. Spent almost 30 years on the dictionary. It cost so much when it came out, though, $15, $20, huge amount in 1828. And Webster died in 1843 without having sold many copies. He traveled around promoting the dictionary, lobbied for copyright law, wrote his own edition of the Bible, compiled a dictionary of medical conditions. He did the first census, and a biography of him argued that Noah Webster would today be diagnosed with obsessive-compulsive personality disorder. It was on this day, 1865, President Abraham Lincoln was shot by John Wilkes Booth in Ford's Theater in Washington, just 5 days after the surrender of the Civil War's Confederate leader, General Robert E. Lee. And a big day in the newspaper business, it's the anniversary of the first self-feeding rotary printing press in Baltimore. William Bullock was the inventor. 1863 was the date. It's the birthday of the journalist Tina Rosenberg, born Brooklyn, 1960, a proponent of what she's called solutions journalism, journalism that doesn't just report bad news but works to change the world, showing how the problems can be overcome. She writes a New York Times column called Fixes, in which she explores solutions to social crises like health care and poverty. She said, "We know that a steady diet of news about violence and corruption and incompetence does create in people depression, apathy, learned helplessness, stress, all kinds of things, and it's really bad for the news business. We are selling a product that people find painful to consume. I think anyone could tell you that that's not a good business model." And it's the birthday of the graphic novelist Daniel Clowes, born in Chicago, 1961, whose comics draw sympathetic portraits of eccentric and lonely and disenfranchised people. Books like Lloyd Llewellyn, Ghost World, and David Boring. Here's a poem by Joyce Sutphen entitled Zippers. Something about the way one side needs to fit into the other end to end and teeth lined up just right happens only when I feel good about the chance that anything will ever come together. What I mean is this. The other day in L.L. Bean, trying on coats from the clearance rack, I found each zipper a challenge, and after a while you couldn't stand to watch me fail and fail again, and so you pulled me close the way one does a child, and for a moment everything came together. A poem entitled Zippers by Joyce Sutphen, used by permission of the poet here on the Writer's Almanac. Be well, do good work, and keep in touch.